In this movie, we're going to have a look at sending some signals to delays, but doing some processing to those signals before the signal gets to the delay. The idea being that we can modify the signal going to the delay. Now, in a lot of cases, you could put the processing before or after the delay effect and get a pretty similar sound. And then in some cases, you get a slightly different result. But we're going to look at just putting the processing before the delay effect, and then you can go ahead and experiment from there. And I'm going to start with a pretty simple setup here. I've got a little vocal phrase, and it's sending to bus 8, which is this setup of processors right here. But I'm going to turn off the send, and we'll just give a listen to the vocal phrase.
Do me a favor.
I'm going to go ahead and send it just to the delay effect, and it's just set up for quarter note delay, a little bit of feedback here. So right now it sounds like this.
Do me a favor. Do me a favor.
Pretty straightforward effect. Now, we do have the ability to filter the effect inside the plugin itself, so we could go ahead and process the delay signal here, do some band limiting.
Do me a favor.
But of course, we can also decide that we want to do it externally for whatever reason. And here, for example, I've got an EQ set up to do some band limiting before the signal gets the tape delay. Sounds like this.
Do me a favor.
I can do other things as well. One of the things I can do is compress the signal before the signal gets to the delay. Now, this is a bit tricky because, of course, the compressor is a gain-sensitive device. So now I have to be careful that if I set the compressor for an effect that I like, I have to remember that if I change the send level, or since it's a post fader send, if I change the track level, it'll change the relationship of the signal to the compressor. I might even decide I would do this as a pre fader send instead, just to eliminate the track fader from being involved in that. But for now, I'm going to leave it as a post fader send. I'll just be sure not to move the track fader or the send level. But the idea here is that I like this delay effect. Again, it sounds like this.
Do me a favor.
But what I want to do is I want to kind of flatten it out so that the signal going to the delay doesn't have quite the same dynamic profile. So here I have the compressor kicked in, a 5-to-1 ratio, pretty fast attack, moderate release. Got the makeup gain set up so that it gives me about the same amount of gain, but it won't have quite the same dramatic dynamic shape as the original vocal.
Do me a favor.
It was just a little flatter overall, and I can combine it with the filtering, which is why I did the filtering external to the tape delay.
Do me a favor.
Like so. The other thing I can do is I can put a gate in front of the vocal, and in this case, the idea is I only want the loudest parts of the vocal to actually come into the delay. And again, it's a gain sensitive setup, so I've got a threshold here. I got to be very careful about, you know, once I set the threshold just the way I want it, I don't want to change the send level because it will change the relationship to the gate. But this will maybe give me something a little more chopped up, because only the loudest parts of the vocal will come through.
Do me a favor.
So it's not quite as thick as an effect. It's a little more stuttery, a little more interesting maybe. And I can again combine that with the band limiting.
Do me a favor.
These are all ideas I can try with a vocal in a music production. Let's look at a different example here. This is a drum beat. And it's going to go to bus 5. So it's going to go to this set of plugins here. And it's going to a delay, which is a fairly standard. It's a dotted eighth delay. So right now, the drum beat by itself. Now, going to this dotted eighth delay. And then from here, I can try all kinds of things. Here's an EQ, for example. Before we get to the delay, the idea is that I've got the band limiting set up here. Similar kind of thing. I think that would work better because it's a thinner delay effect with that drum beat. But I can actually do things I can't do with the filter inside the delay plugin itself. For example, add a little bit of a resonant boost here. Which I think gives it a little more character. And again, it's something I couldn't do just using the filters in the delay plugin. I could do the same idea with the gate, and the same issue applies regarding the fact it's a gain-sensitive setup now, but the idea here is that only the loudest drum beats will come through. And here, I've also filtered the key signal so that only a particular range of frequencies is going to trigger the gate. And again, if I wanted to get the band limiting involved here with that little resonant peak, I would put it after the gate so that the gate is based on the level of the signal coming to it from the track, and then I reshape it. It's a neat effect off of that drum beat, and it's not a complicated sound because it's simpler than if I just sent the drum beat straight away. I can also get some other plugins involved that we've looked at already. For example, good old auto filter. So here, auto filter is set up with envelope and LFO, modulation of filter cutoff, a bit of resonance here. So now we have that's got a lot of movement to it. It's quite interesting. And I could even get these guys involved, both the gate and the channel EQ with that little resonant boost. And again, I've got some interesting sounds here I can work with. Spectral gate. Here I have spectral gate set up, and in this case, spectral gate is set up with a particular threshold setting. So again, it's a gain sensitive setup. And here I have the super energy boosted, and I have only a particular range of frequencies involved via the center frequency and bandwidth setting here. So and that's an interesting sound you don't hear a lot. So it could give my beat a little more of a unique flavor, and I could combine that with some of the other ideas as well. This spectral gate here is set up just a little differently in that it's got the super energy turned down and the sub energy turned up here. So now it's the low amplitude parts of the signal that are going to come through the delay. And that adds a lot of nice surface motion. I can combine that with the gate, so less activity because only the loud elements are involved. And so forth. And the idea is I can really combine all kinds of ideas about signal processing into a chain of effects and then use that to send to a standard delay effect to get something interesting happening. I can do this in sound design as well. Here's an example. This one over here is a sound we've heard before. It's somebody just manipulating some a ceramic tile or something. Now, in this case, I actually have this one pulled all the way down, and I have set up as a pre-fader send to this stack of plugins. And the only thing I have right now is this EQ involved, which just takes out some bottom end and takes a little edge off of the sound. And then I can try putting it into a delay effect. And in this case, it's a kind of a slap delay kind of effect with a bit of feedback. And I'm using the diffuse mode of the tape head, and also I have some band limiting going on, but notice I have a bit of mangling with that flutter and also LFO modulation of the delay time. I'm just trying to create a more interesting sound design element I might use in a production, and I can add things like, for example, in this case, modulation delay, set up to do some short delay effects, but I have some pretty high feedback and a good bit of modulation with all of these LFOs modulating this delay time. And I can even get good old Spectral Gate involved here. And it's set up with a very narrow range of the frequency spectrum involved, but I have modulation here of the center frequency a little bit and the bandwidth a bit more. So now I have some interesting combinations of ideas here. To create totally new sounds, I'm going to swap out this tape delay for one that's set up for an even shorter effect, a very short a delay effect here, quite a bit of feedback, quite a bit of flutter, like so. But again, it's a much shorter a delay and has more feedback here. Can even get them both involved. And what was once just somebody manipulating some tiles is now a really interesting kind of a sci-fi sound design element that I could use in a variety of contexts. So that's a bit about processing delay sends for anything from doing some music mixing to doing some sound design.